Welcome class. This is our lecture on ordinary differential equation. We must understand that ordinary differential equation is in part B of paper 1. And this is a very important topic. A lot of questions are asked from this area. Before we get started, let me start with writing the syllabus. First topic, that is formation of ordinary differential equation. Second that we have to study is equation of first order and first degree, and in this one you are also going to study about integrating factor. Now there are a lot of variety of questions in this part. We have separable variation, we have to separate separable variable in this one, and then we have to reduce it to separable variable. Then other type is our homogeneous equation, then we can use it to reduce to homogeneous equation. Then we have linear equation, and then finally Bernoulli equation. So that is the ambit of this topic. So there are a lot of variety of methods to solve in this area of equation of first order and first degree. And here integrating factor is also mentioned in the syllabus. So particularly a question is asked premised on this integrating factor. Third is orthogonal trajectories. Here invariably alternatively questions are asked in, and they are in Cartesian as well as polar coordinate, and this is a part of application of differential equation that we are going to study. Fourth is equation of first order but not of first degree. Here we are going to study about equation solvable for x, y, p, and in syllabus special mention is made about Clairaut equation and singular solution. And the fifth part that we will study of this is second and higher order differential equation, that is linear only, linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Here we will be talking about complementary function, which is explicitly mentioned in syllabus, and to find particular integral also of variety of functions and general solution. Similarly, we have to study about in the sixth part about second order only, not higher orders. So that is second order linear differential equation with variable coefficient. Here basically we are dealing with three methods, that is UV method and normal form and changing the independent variable. So we will be taking up this one also, and the seventh one that we have to study is your Euler-Cauchy equation, and question is asked on this mostly, and it is very much known format we have, so we can solve it very easily. We can identify that equation and solve this question. And eighth is we have to solve differential equation by variation of parameters. Here one part of the solution is known and by that we have to use to find the other part of the solution, and this method is explicitly mentioned. And question is focal area is also this area, because this method requires laborious method and it takes quite time to find out A and B, that is the parameters. And last one is our Laplace and inverse Laplace transform and their properties. Okay, and we have to also study about properties of Laplace transform of elementary function, and we have to use initial value problem for second order linear differential equation with constant coefficient. So we started our channel Arbhat Ashram with this one. We have solved, we are having 12 lectures on this, and we have actually studied this one and we have done this one. So now before we begin to study all those things, let me first do the analysis of what is the weightage of this ordinary differential equation in recent years. So I will just write it over here, the years and the marks. In 2018, it was asked for 106 marks in paper 1 of part B, where there are compulsory questions and particular questions also. In 2017, 2016, 2015, 2014, and 2013. So in 2018 it was asked for 106 marks, and in 2017 it was asked for 87 marks. So we can see this area carries a lot of weightage. And if you do this, it is just methodically done, then you can score these marks very easily. In 2016, I can see the question was asked for 80 marks. In 2015, it was for 70 marks. 40 was 100 marks. And 2013 was 70 marks. So this is very important to do the analysis, and we can see especially in 2018 the marks have drastically increased, the marks that has been asked in this area. So this is the analysis part we will take up from the first itself, and today we are going to start with the formulation of ordinary differential equation. And before we start with forming the differential equation, we will start with some of the plenary and basic discussion with that. First of all, we are going to talk about what actually is a differential equation. Differential equation is basically an interplay between a function and its derivative. It's a sort of relationship between a function and its derivative. If I write differential equation, it consists of one or more dependent, one or more dependent variable and its derivative with respect to one or more independent variable. Alright, so we have to understand actually before what actually is differential equation. In the simple terms, if we write as any function y x dy by dx d square y by dx square to dn y x n is equal to 0. So this is of the format of a differential equation. here we can see, here we have x as independent variable. If we write any function y of fx is equal to y is equal to fx, so here x is our what? X is independent variable and y is our dependent variable. So y is depending on x. So we are very much clear what is independent variable and what is dependent variable. So we are arguing that it consists of one or more dependent variable. So we can rightly say that a differential equation can contain more than one dependent variable. That means if I write in mathematical terms, I can write d square x by dt square plus dy dt plus x is equal to y. This is a differential equation. See, here we are having independent variable, that is t, but dependent variables are x and y. Both of them are depending on t. So we can very easily say that differential equation is having one or more dependent variable and their relation with the derivative with respect to independent variable. So we have other classifications, and now we are going to study ordinary differential equation. In ordinary differential equation, if I further divide it into differential equation, is bifurcated into ordinary differential equation, partial differential equation, and sometimes total differential equation also, which is not in syllabus. We are primarily dealing with ODE and PD. ODE is in paper 1 part B and PD is in paper 2 part B. Alright, so we will now try to make a parallel differentiation between ODE and PD. So we are going to write a definition for ordinary differential equation and also make parallel differentiation between ODE and PD. Ordinary differential equation is involving ordinary derivative. Ordinary derivative with respect to single independent variable. All right. Whereas partial differential equation, it involves partial derivative with respect to two or more independent variable. So what do we mean by when we say that ordinary derivative with respect to single derivative, single independent variable? In ordinary differential equation, if we write dy by dx is equal to cos of x, alright. So we are seeing here, we are only having one independent variable, okay. But if we write any partial differential equation, dou u by dou x square plus dou u by dou y square plus dou u by dou z square. So we can see we are having more than one, that is at least two or more. So we are having x and y as two or more independent variable. Here having three independent variables, so, and one dependent variable u. So I think we are in a very good position to make a clear distinction between what is difference between ordinary differential equation and partial differential equation. Alright, so now we are going to further make some of the comments on ordinary differential equation, because this is a basis for ordinary differential equation, and we are going to study in this course especially ordinary differential equation and not partial differential equation. So if I write any equation as say dy by dx at x is equal to y of x at 1, can we say that is this a differential equation? No, this is not a differential equation. Why? Because we are computing y at x plus 1 and the derivative dy by dx at x. So this is not a differential equation. Now if someone asks that dy by dx 0 to x e to the power x of s y of s d of s. Can we say that is this a differential equation? Again, this is not a differential equation. Why? Because the y that we are trying to find out is in the integral, and on the RHS we can see that y is computed from 0 to s x, whereas here differential derivative dy by dx we are finding at x. So this is not again a differential equation. Alright, so we have made the clear cut distinction and what is differential equation and what is not, and we have given the logic and argument behind this. Now proceeding further, some of the more concepts that are important to this course, that we have to define what is order and degree. Now I will make a distinction between order and degree. Order and degree. Order is, it is the order of highest order derivative appearing in differential equation. Alright, and what is degree? Degree, it is the highest exponent of highest order derivative appearing in differential equation. Okay, but there is a caveat. What is that? After radicals, fractional powers or negative powers of derivative is removed. So this is the distinction between order and degree. So if I'm going to write an example, we will be very much clear with this. If I say plus y is equal to tan x, we have just said that order is the highest order derivative appearing in the differential equation. So the order of this differential equation is how much? 2. And what is the degree? Degree is 1, because it is the highest exponent. What is the highest exponent of this order? That is 1. So we can say degree is 1. Okay, so this is one example. Like this we can give lot of examples in this. So another example that I would like to take is that if we say, suppose we have dy by dx square is equal to 1 plus dy by dx whole square, and this is our 3 by 2. Now we have to find the order and degree. We are just saying that it is in fraction part, so we have to remove it. So what we do, if we take the square of this, this becomes square and this becomes 1 plus dy by dx whole square. So first we have to talk about order. So order is, this is the highest order appearing here. So order is 2. And what is the degree? Degree is also 2, because that is the exponent to this part 2. So we have got order and degree. Invariably questions like what is order and degree, that will not be asked in examination, but these are the fundamental building blocks for our differential equation. Once we know all of these things, we are in a better position to solve questions. Alright, and one more topic that is important for this part is our linear differential equation. What actually is linear differential equation? We have to be very thorough with this. A linear differential equation, if I say, that is like linear differential equation, it is of the format yn plus p1 yn minus 1 plus p2 yn minus 2 to Pn y is equal to q of x. Okay, so in linear differential equation, what happens? The dependent variable and its derivative is of the first order. We can readily see from this. Is it not of the first degree, not order? So we can write it as plus p1 x and minus 1. Similarly, p2 dn y by dx n minus 2. And y is equal to q of x. So the degree in all of this is 1. So our first argument is that the dependent variable and its derivative must be of first degree. Alright. It is imperative that it should be must of the first degree, and it should there not be in higher powers and of derivative, and not in higher power or products of derivative. What I am saying, if I write x plus y whole square dy by dx is equal to 1, can we call this as linear? No, we cannot call this as linear. Why? Because product is coming here. X square dy by dx plus y square dy by dx plus 2xy dy by dx. So you can see that the dependent variable and the derivative is coming in product. Alright, so we cannot call this as a linear differential equation. But if I write as, say, dy by dx plus x square y is equal to x cube, can we call this a linear equation? Yes, this is very much a linear differential equation, because its dependent variable is, first of all, is in the degree 1, and no product is happening with the derivative sign. So these are the basics concept that we have to begin with before we take up the formation of differential equation.